This is Brian Gowal, who works on text analysis, which is a really important problem for search engines if we want to be able to do a better job of identifying the right documents. So tell us how that works.
So there's lots of different approaches, but the model that we tend to take transforms them into a really nice hash table representation. So text is long and unwieldy and unstructured and prose flows and goes, but computers like things that are nice and structured and amenable in familiar things like lists, hash tables, etc. So what we've got is a way to turn unstructured text into a data structure that computers are really happy with. And one of those is the hash table in general. So we can start with a document that says Obama announces candidacy, and we can turn that into a representation of that document, you know, an imperfect representation that just says, okay, let's keep track of every word and the number of times that word appeared in a document. So we would just go through and say Obama. So go to the hash table and hash Obama and make sure the value associated with it is 1. Similarly, announces hashes to 1 and candidacy hashes to 1. And if we were dealing with longer documents, these values would grow and the number of elements in the hash table would grow as well. And then we come across document 2, where we can represent that with a whole new hash table. Barack Obama elected, Barack maps to 1, Obama maps to 1, elected maps to 1. And now, you know, if it also said president down here, we'd add more and more keys and keep track of the value associated with each one. And when it comes time to relating documents to each other, like we would do with our search engine, we can look and say, hey, you know what? There's an overlap between these two documents and the fact that they both used Obama. And if we've got enough documents, and if there's enough patterns between them, then we can start saying, hey, you know what? I'm seeing this pattern of Barack shows up in a lot of them, or candidacy or announcements seem to come from him a lot. And now you've got a way of expanding this keyword that maybe you were searching for Obama. The search engine can think, oh, when you say Obama, you're really talking about this wide pantheon of topics that all have to do with the 44th presidency.
So how did you get started working on this?
Well, I was an electrical engineer, and I went from circuits to signals to statistical signal processing. And it turns out I was working on, you know, how do you tell if a cell phone is sending a 1 or a 0? And the math behind that wound up being broadly applicable to general problems, including how do we tell if this email is spam or not? And that's kind of the entree to text processing in general from my background.
So what's the next step then?
Well, a lot of the stuff that we work with all comes down to being able to compare two documents and then finding out how that comparison maps to whatever your target is, you know, detecting spam or not. And all that works really well if the documents are next to each other, living close to each other within a single system. But that gives you a maximum of how many documents can analyze. So distributing the solutions and solvers to these problems is, I think, where a lot of energy is being put forth.